Learn how to create custom bindings for Azure Functions in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Azure Function bindings are great. They help you to communicate with services without writing the plumbing to connect to them. And if you need a binding that doesn't come out of the box, you can create a custom one. I've already created a custom binding in this class library. You can download the source code for this sample application at this address. To create a custom binding, you should create a .NET standard class library, which you can use in your Azure function. Let's go through it to see how you can create a custom binding. This is the binding itself. The binding is able to read the contents from files. It is a class that has the extension attribute on it and that implements the iExtension config provider interface. Because of this, it has the initialize method, which I use to add a binding rule for the myFileReader binding attribute. This binds input values that I define in the Azure function to the binding. Let me show you. This is the attribute. It has been tagged as a binding, and it has one property, which is a location. This will contain the location of the files to read, so something like ctemp. And this has the autoresolve attribute, which means that it will try and fill the location parameter with a value from the configuration system, like one that we store in local.settings.json. So that's the attribute. And this is the file reader model that we use. This contains the full file path and content, which is the content of the file. This rule says that we fill the model with this method, build item from attribute. This does the actual work. It gets the args, which is the attribute containing the location, and it uses that to see if the file exists, and if it does, read its contents. And it then takes the location and content and returns that as the myFileReader model. This is the custom binding. To make it work, there is some plumbing, like this class. This initializes the custom binding when the Azure function starts up. It still references web jobs because Azure functions are built on web jobs and are the evolution of them. It then uses an extension method, which is this one, to initialize the custom binding. Now to the function. This function project references the class library of the custom binding. It is a function that is triggered by HTTP, so I can just call it from a browser. And it has a route defined that takes a name parameter, which is the name of the file that we want to read. It also has the myFileReader binding here, which has the input parameter of location, which is made up of file path and name. And once it has read the file, it simply returns the content. And the file path is defined in here. In my case, it is the test folder on my C drive. And that is here. Here I have created two simple text files with some text in them. Alright, let's try it out. I'll build it and run it. And here it is. This is a console that shows my Azure function running locally at this URL. Let's try that out in the browser. As it takes a name parameter, all I need to do is add the name of the document. There it is, the content of document A. Now let's try to get the content of document B. And there it is. It works. Custom bindings for Azure functions are really useful because they allow you to make Azure functions work for your specific scenario. Go and check it out.